Oxford. The word is synonymous with academic excellence. Created in 1116, it's the oldest university in the English-speaking world. It's actually a collection of 68 different colleges all gathered in the heart of the old city. And it's here that 22,000 students set out to earn their precious degree.
It's an international, I mean, we have 120 different nationalities at Oxford. We've numerous number of presidents, former presidents of the United States and prime ministers of this country and other countries across the world.
More than 30 world leaders have studied at Oxford, as well as countless leading figures in literature and the arts. Oxford is the alma mater of 36 British prime ministers, more than 50 Nobel laureates, all helping the university to carve out its formidable academic reputation. And yet, still, there is a place for sport.
I think clearly Oxford is an academic institution focusing on academic excellence and performance in the academic field, but sport plays an incredibly high level of importance with the individual students who come here, and the history and the famous sportsmen and women that have come through Oxford.
The tennis player John Boland was an Oxford student, the first British Olympic champion, and the first of 158 Oxford medalists, many from abroad. One of them was the only Olympian to win gold at both the Summer and the Winter Games, the American Eddie Egan. And there was Roger Bannister. It was on May the 6th, 1954, that Bannister became the first man to run a mile in under 4 minutes.
I think this was this breaking of this barrier, this four-minute barrier. It was very, very romantic, and it had world publicity, and it was, of course, people were writing about it many years before, saying it was physically impossible. They said it was impossible to break this barrier, and the fact that he achieved it on his home track of his athletics club, of his university where he'd studied, I just think it touched lots of people's imaginations and basically showed that anything could be achieved.
Yet the sport that Oxford is best known for is rowing and the boat race.
I think the most well-known ones are probably the rowing through the boat race, because, I mean, there's over 6 million people watch that live on the Thames every year. But still, Oxford and Cambridge stays very high in people's consciousness about competition between universities.
Oxford against Cambridge, one of the oldest sporting events in the world. Created in 1829, it's been run annually since 1856, except during the First and Second World Wars. In 1877, there was a dead heat. In 1912, both crews sank. But every year, it still captures the imagination. The boat race is part of the nation's cultural fabric. But although it's a well-established tradition, this year there was a tweak, with a women's race run on the same day for the very first time. The university women had been competing since 1927, but always on a different stretch of water and on a different day. But now, in 2015, on that first race on the big London course, Oxford would take the honours. And they did it, watched by more than 200,000 spectators along the banks of the Thames. As far as the men are concerned, well, Cambridge have won 81 times, but Oxford have taken 11 of the last 16 victories. And with this one held in April, the dark blues notched up victory number 79. And of course, an historic double victory, men and women.
What a fantastic year. You know, for us, this is just the most wonderful day to mark this historic occasion. I'm so pleased for Oxford University Women's Boat Club with their double victory. You know, I'm so pleased for ISIS, our reserve crew, winning in some style. And for our crew as well, to win, you know, in that definitive style. I'm just so happy. This is wonderful.
Nothing captures the university's spirit of friendly competition more than the boat race. But the rivalry between the two universities is not confined to rowing by any means.
The higher profile ones, of course, are the boat race on the Thames and the rugby at Twickenham, but we actually have over 180 different varsity matches a year across 50 or so different sports. So it's very wide and it permeates down to all levels of competition and standing.
Oxford provides its students with 87 sports clubs to allow them to complement their academic education with sport at all levels. The university provides the finance, the infrastructure, the administrative staff, and the coaches.
From the students is 2,500 who play university sport, another 6,000 at college level. So it's approaching 10,000 people, I think, in all that take part in membership of the gym, the pool, or sport. So it's 50% maybe of the university population are involved in sport here.
And yet, despite all the passion surrounding it, sport is certainly not a priority at Oxford University, and the students have to be aware of that.
Je pense que la priorité absolue, c'est nos résultats académiques.
The first priority, of course, is our academic results. So if you ever start to be less successful, they'd immediately tell us to ease up on the training. The priority are the results. We're here to study, that's clear. We know that sport is good, but it really is more important to succeed in our studies.
Le sport, c'est très bien, mais qu'il faut vraiment qu'on réussisse nos études.
While across the world, sport is becoming more professional, at universities like this, there's growing pressure to produce top-quality academic graduates. It begs the question over the future of high-performance sport at Oxford, despite its impressive history.
It is amazing. I think, I mean, there is the range of sports that we have excelled at the Olympics is quite amazing, and it does go back many years. I think things have changed recently. The onset of professionalism in the last 20, 30 years in many Olympic sports means that things have moved on, and Oxford are not able to necessarily deliver, produce the same number of athletes at that elite level. But that's down to the balance of being academically brilliant and sportingly brilliant, and I think increasingly in the modern time, it's incredibly hard to replicate both aspects of somebody's life.
John Roycroft, the Oxford University Director of Sport, on the achievements and the challenges ahead. Still to come on the programme, the big annual Sport Accord Convention in Sochi, where sport comes together with business. And the inspiration of Romania's Minister for Sport, the great Gabriela Szabo.
National University Sports Federation brings together millions of students worldwide around the same values, excellence in mind and body. Thousands of students, hundreds of universities participate in FISU events, the rendezvous for the best student athletes. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.